big enough.
Hi, how are you? My name is Fridah, and the show that we're going to do right now is 5 Minutes with Fridah, where we give you a tidbit of 5 minutes into somebody's life. And today we're going to concentrate on Elsaphan Njora. So yeah, he is actor, dancer, poet extraordinaire. And we're going to just break down a couple of things about him, and hopefully you learn something new.
Play it twice, have a good time.
When did it all start?
I feel like since I was born, I was performing. Because as children, we were always performing something for our parents or something like that. But it started in 2006. I cleared high school in 2005.
Okay.
In 2006, we had this ex-cans group.
Yeah.
I was cast in a play. The first play I've ever done, it was called 40 Minutes a Chair.
Mm-hmm.
40 Minutes to the Chair. And immediately after, I was like, this thing is easy.
It is really?
Nice. I mean, not easy. Like, it's easy to the heart or easy.
Oh, yeah.
You know, like, I'm finding the cues easier to do.
Yeah.
Of course, I didn't know a lot. But I was like, yeah, this comes naturally.
Yeah.
And I also started a spoken word event.
Yeah.
2006.
Yeah.
December 15th, called Eve of Poetry,
yes,
which is now known as EOP Nation.
Yeah.
So that's 10 years now.
Actually, I want to talk about EOP Nation and your spoken word.
It started in 2003.
Yeah.
Integrated English. I don't know if you remember.
Yeah, I remember Integrated English.
Yeah. So there's this poem called Squire Curtis.
Yes.
Okay, the full name is The Ballad of Squire Curtis.
Yeah.
I read it, and that's when I knew I wanted to write poetry.
That's your Twitter name, isn't it?
Yeah, that's my Twitter name.
It affected Squire, you that much?
Yeah. It's a poem about this guy who falls in love with, madly in love with this woman, marries her, takes her to his home.
Yeah.
Yeah. Then he gets tired of her. And now he plots to kill her. Then he takes her to the forest.
Okay.
He kills her. Then he comes back home. And guess who's coming down the stairs? The same woman he killed. And so he goes crazy. And this is all in stanzas. But I could feel the wind in the forest. I could feel the love. I could feel the hate. Just by using simple words and phrasing and the stanzas.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, why should I write prose? This is it.
Let's talk about 51 and your work.
No, I won't talk about it.
Thanks.
When we celebrated 50 years,
yeah.
It was confirmed something that I knew from a very young age,
mm-hmm.
that
yeah.
we face trauma
mm-hmm.
as a nation, and we have been programmed to believe that we can only follow a system. We're not going to take risks and stuff like that. We have so many dreams and so many creative ideas, but we'll never follow through.
Okay.
So we're only happy with the fact that we can do it, yeah. Not that we have done it.
Okay.
For example, why is it that we have to wait for Hollywood to do Queen of Cattle? These are our stories.
Yeah.
What don't we have?
Yeah.
So I coined something, 51. I want to publish 51 poems each year for 51 years.
Okay.
And I want to have performances of those books every year.
Yeah.
I started March 15th. I did my first show.
Mm-hmm.
And I was almost, I didn't know then, but it's like I was almost teaching people how to appreciate what I can do.
Yeah. And how is it working with June Kashui? Because I saw that she was the director.
Yes,
the
she was the director. I mean, first you have to understand that June is years in terms of experience,
yes.
in terms of ahead of me,
and very many. Yeah.
Yeah. She's amazing. She has a fan.
Yeah.
She launched her album.
Yes, she did.
She's still a performer.
Yes.
She's an actor. She's
yeah.
an, she's a, she does improv comedy. But she still makes time.
Yeah.
Still made time to direct me, to give me advice and stuff. Yeah.
Now let's go to the acting. First of all, congratulations on Kati Kati. You won a tip.
Yeah.
How is that like? Just being part of internationally acclaimed. You know.
To be honest, yeah, bigger victory is
yeah.
I worked with Obi, who's an amazing director.
Okay.
Yeah. And I worked with different actors.
Yeah.
That I went to Savo East for 3 weeks to shoot this film.
Yeah.
And that was one, that's my best experience in film so far. But for me, I want to see more. I'm more like, but
what's
we won a TIFF.
Now we have to win a grab. Now we have
now
to win
we
an
have
Oscar.
To, yeah. Or rather, at least not even to win. We have to make more films.
Yeah.
And films that move, you know, people. So, yeah.
Okay. What is your what do you feel like your purpose on this earth is?
My purpose is to create.
Yes.
And is to create here in Kenya and in Africa. And I feel like that would be enough to spread to the world.
Yeah. What is something that people don't know about you that you're willing to say?
I love cats more than I love human beings. Actually, more than babies. I mean, it's not that I'm not going to take care of a baby.
But
cats.
Really?
Cats are amazing. They are the size of a baby, and also they can walk
by themselves.
Fend for themselves.
Okay then, cats before babies.
Oh my God, let me tell you, if waking up in the morning, then I go through like Instagram.
Yes.
I followed certain people who have
cats.
Cats, you know, like and lions and stuff like that. Like, this is my reaction. So I'm like scrolling, or there's a chick, or your chick is like, you know,
whatever.
And then I see a cat, I'm just like, oh my God.
Are you serious?
I'm not lying.
Do you have a cat?
No, I don't have a cat, but there's a neighborhood cat, which is a stray cat. Okay, a couple of them.
But you take care of him.
And we talk.
Them,
yeah.
You talk.
We talk, yeah.
And that was 5 minutes with Fridah. And thank you so much to Elsaphan Njora for joining us. Bye.
Alafu.
See you next week.
What to a kitchen?
Okay. Bye. Haitoshi kuzima hii beat so smooth. Oh, so nice. Play it.